Hey, what's up?
Hey, Rico.
Rico.
How's it going?
Good, good.
What up, Rico? Oh dang, we're stacked. Look at this. We got like furnaces. We got like the whole setup. Ooh, some nice
Yeah,
little
getting a
final.
little getting a little conversation going here on the chat.
Oh yeah? Nice.
People not thinking the church is real. They think it's amazing. They want to come check it out.
Isn't that funny?
They will.
They want to bring C4.
That's all right. Bring it.
Oh, we've been.
Yeah,
We've been.
That's mild.
That's mild. I've just seen that one time in Rust Empire.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Yeah. I don't think I've seen as many explosions that I have in that one Rust Empire.
Yep.
People were driving cars in and horses, and I think every C4 rocket on the server went off in that church.
Yep. That it wasn't too laggy either. That's a pretty good server to
no,
be honest.
No, I agree.
Looks good, boys. Looks
Yo,
good.
Fab. I have an idea. The boombox, the portable one. Make some for a giveaway.
Who's this? 1, 2, 3. Who's that?
You know, we used to give giveaways after church. Yeah.
Oh, DJ, is there an issue that I'm doing more than one announcement in the chat?
I don't think so. Did somebody say something?
Oh no, you said that. Just do one announcement.
I think well, the guy, I just told him the only time we'd be talking about the church is before church, but I didn't say how much. Like, I
yeah,
didn't say like
I
one
started 15 minutes out.
Yeah, I think it's fine.
All
right. Going over spam it.
I'm not. I do 15. I do 10, I do 5, but they're asking questions, so I'm just.
Oh, yeah, if you answer, if you're, oh, yeah, especially if you're answering questions, that's fine. I think they're pretty chill. They just, yeah, they just don't want it all 24/7. We're all just, like, dominating the server. Rico, man, I caught your message this morning on YouTube for a little bit. That was pretty good, man.
Nice.
Yeah,
yeah,
Rico was live on the YouTubes. IRL sermon.
Oh, nice.
It's a nice avatar you got.
Right? Like 16K.
I feel like you needed some like wolf skin or, I don't know, some metal gear. Oh. What happens if you get... Oh, okay, never mind.
Did you manage to pick up the boombox? You're fine. Oh, here.
That was
close. No.
Oh, for some reason, my mic...
Fat, do you still have a VIP?
Yeah, tell them, yeah, you can TP to me or whatever.
Oh, I gotta send out. Alright, so clan invite.
Oh, my bad. I didn't see you were doing that fat. My bad.
Clan invite.
Watch out for there. For the.
Yes. Slash.
How much you.
Oh, is that a bad heli?
Oh, that's a personal one, I think, actually.
Oh, okay.
I'll let you start answering these, DJ.
Okay,
I'm getting,
cool.
I'm getting like 10 frames per second for some reason. But I think that might be my end. Like, the rest has been pretty rough.
What is the church for? Yeah. Your spiritual well-being? I don't know. It's getting too deep and philosophical for me, so I'll let the professionals handle that. Rico, DJ, you can take that off. That's the way I looked at it, Fat. Like, are you serious? You have to ask what church is for.
Right?
Yeah. Just a drone here, man. That's above my pay grade.
Anyone has a little bit of fuel?
It's a fair question when you're in Rust. You're like, what the?
Yeah.
That's what I said. I'll let the professionals handle that one.
Right, I'm gonna mute in game.
New friends.
Hey, DJ.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out if my mic's not working in Rust. It hasn't been for a few days.
Huh?
Trying to figure out if it works. If it doesn't, I might not be able to do the prayer at the end. But
oh,
I'll
okay.
Let you know through chat if it works or not.
All right. Cool. Options, controls, check, 1, 2. Hey everybody, welcome to church. We're going to get started in a few minutes. Just feel free to hang out. I'm sure Heli will be done by then. And then we'll get started with church. So good to see everyone today. Welcome to Rusty Church, new time, 5:30. Yeah, so we'll get started very soon. What's up, M96? How you doing? I kind of want to watch who's taking Heli out there.
Is it the bat Heli?
No, I think it's a personal Heli. Oh, they got mowed down. You see that? Ouch. Gotta hurt.
That's flying overhead here.
Probably next time we should be geared up to take it down if it attacks us.
Pretty good. Oh, no, it's on fire. Someone else
took it down?
Yeah, it's smoking. It ain't gonna attack us.
We're all good. Nice. Columbo, you got baptized today. What's up, Twitch? Hey, congratulations, Columbo. That's pretty sweet. What's up, Dark Buy followers? No, thank you. All right. Let's give that give the heli a minute to chill out, and then we'll start church. Problem. Hey, what's up, Poppy? How's it going?
Hello.
What's up? Is that Rico? Oh, Marco. What's up, Marco? Did you guys create a new team? I don't see you guys anywhere.
Oh, yeah, we did, actually.
That's
if
cool.
You want, I can invite you.
Yeah, join me after, so I can just leave it for now. Actually, invite me, because I was going to say, just because of the, Wait, where'd you go? Oh, there.
Leave your team.
Oh, that's right. Very nice. Take down that heli already. Should we go help? Oh, we can't help it, can we? It's like imprinted to them.
Because once they start doing damage, it's just like assigned to them, unless they caught it.
Yeah.
As well.
Gotcha. Hey, Beaky, what's up? Beaky's on Twitch. Everybody say hi, Beaky.
Hey, Beaky.
Hi, Beaky.
What up, Beaky? Well, it's a private heli. I don't think it's going to attack the church, although it did attack us the other day. Yeah, we built the church yesterday because Wipe was yesterday. Yeah, all right, time to start church. Let's do it, man. How about that? Have you ever been to a church where you had to wait for the heli to be destroyed before church started? So anyways, welcome everybody. We're going to go ahead and get started with the Rusty Church. Want to say hello to everybody here in world. And I want to say hello to everyone watching on Twitch. What's good? I hope things are going well for you in your part of the world. If this is your first time to Rusty Church, whether it's here or on Twitch, this is a real church. I'm an ordained pastor, and this is a real community with leaders and volunteers, which I know is kind of strange. I saw in the chat people were like, you know, what? Kind of like wrap their brain around that. So, yeah, welcome. We got a little bit of a following on TikTok for our Rust Church, so If we post to TikTok, what's up, TikTok? Nothing but love. I hope you're doing good over in your part of the world as well. If you're new, this church service isn't too long, probably 20 minutes thereabouts. And I'm going to share a sermon with you very soon. We're going to start the book of Matthew. So we have churches all across like virtual reality and as well as MMOs like Final Fantasy and Rust. And so generally speaking, we're all teaching the same passage of the Bible. So we're going to be looking at the book of Matthew today, and I'll talk about that in a little bit. This will be like an introductory message for what's coming. So nothing too crazy going on today as far as the sermon. It's going to like set the stage for what's to come. Anyway, so we'll talk about the book of Matthew here in just a little bit. But before we do, I'm going to just open up with a word of prayer, a prayer of blessing for everyone in here. And then after I pray, Octane's got a few announcements to come up. Okay, Rico, your mic's working beautiful. We got some announcements, and then, we'll get going with our church service for today. God, thank you so much for this time where we can gather together. You say where two or three are gathered, you're there. And I just pray that you bless everyone in here. Whatever they're going through in life, may they be encouraged. May they grow in their faith. May they grow in their love. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Octane, all right, my friend, tell me what's going on, man.
All right. Welcome, everybody. Glad to see more and more people every service coming in here. We want to thank Zombieland for inviting us to their server. For those of you watching this afterwards, Zombieland is such an incredible, incredible server. One of the coolest ones I've seen. So even if you believe in the church or not, come check it out. It's a great server at Zombieland. Also, if you want to learn a little bit more about what we are, again, here's this church in Rust. Can't wrap my head around this. Go to mmo.church. As Pastor DJ said, we're on VR, we're on Final Fantasy, Altspace. It's just incredible to go see. So please go to mmo.church to see what we're all about. If you're looking for a prayer, you need something in your life, doesn't matter what it is, doesn't matter how big, how small, out front we have a mailbox. You can put whatever your prayer one or whatever you need a prayer for, put it on a piece of paper and stick it in the mailbox, and we'll be sure to have that and have that done. But I just want to welcome everybody. Thank you. Anybody that wants to contribute, you know, we're always looking for mats. You know, if you have some extra wood that you want to give us or extra metal to keep up, please let us know. We're always welcome. We'll take, you know, a little bit or a lot. And also, we are a real church. If you want to donate to the church, if you go to mmo.church, you'll see where you can actually do some of those donations. But I'm going to pass it over back to Pastor DJ, and he's going to tell us a little bit more.
All right. Thank you so much. Yeah, yeah, Octane. You know, actually, I posted on TikTok. I said, hey, if you guys want to help out build the church, come chop some wood. And we had some people from TikTok. They don't play the server, but they're like, I'm going to come in here. They chop some wood. They put it in the Dropbox. Oh, that reminds me, Fat, we need a Dropbox. So that people, when they come, they can, you know, donate some wood to the church. But yeah, that's awesome. And let's see, what was the other thing Octane said that sparked a thought? I can't remember what it was, but yeah, Zombieland, thank you so much for having us here. We really appreciate it. And yeah, so let's jump into the sermon for today, everybody. Like I said before, this is just an introductory sermon of what's coming. All of our churches are studying this passage of scripture right here, the book of Matthew. So Matthew was a follower of Jesus Christ, and that's who we're going to be talking about. And he wrote down the things that he saw and he heard. And Matthew chapter 1 actually, on the outset, looks kind of boring. Like, it's just a list of names, like this person was born to this person, was born to this person. But really, you have to think of this like your favorite Netflix or Hulu or Apple Plus or what is it called, Disney Plus episode or like miniseries. Maybe you like watching The Mandalorian, or maybe you like watching, you know, Cowboy Bebop or something like that. And you notice how the first episode sets the tone. Maybe there isn't a lot of drama or fighting, or it's kind of setting up the stage for what's coming. And so that's the same idea here in Matthew chapter 1. It's going to seem like, oh, there's not a whole lot going on. But really, it's introducing the characters. It's giving almost like a prequel. And so we're not going to read the whole chapter. I encourage you to go and do that yourself. Just Google Matthew chapter 1. But we're just going to touch on the highlights. And then in the coming weeks, we're going to see this epic story that's going to be told. And so I want to encourage you, and I was telling all our other churches about this, like, I encourage you to either, you know, come every Sunday. If you can't come, watch the live stream on YouTube. Or if you can't watch that, go ahead and just read it. Just Google Matthew in Bible. Because let's say in a couple of weeks we're on episode 5. Have you ever had someone come in to watch your show in the middle of the season and they're like, who's that person? Why are they doing that? And you're like, you should have watched the first few episodes, right? And so it's kind of the same idea there. One way or another, keep up with the episodes, whether it's your own reading, whether it's watching on YouTube, or whether it's actually being here on at Rusty Church. So, like I said, let's look at the first few verses. And then I need to grab that over here. There we go. So here's how Matthew starts out. Seems kind of boring, but again, he's setting the stage for what's to come. He says, these are the ancestors of Jesus Christ. The book of Matthew, even though it's titled Matthew, it's about Jesus Christ, who has come to this earth because he loves us. And we're going to talk more about that in a minute. Some people think that God is full of lightning bolts and judgment, and he's really angry. But really, he's full of love and compassion for all of us. So here's what he says. These are the descendants of Jesus Christ, a descendant of King David. And by the way, King David there is from David and Goliath. If you ever heard of that ancient story, Jesus comes from the line of King David. And of Abraham. Abraham, let's pause there, is a really interesting character because God told Abraham in the Old Testament, like long before this book was written, that all nations of the world would be blessed through Abraham. So before Jesus even got on the scene, God was saying, listen, I love the world so much, all nations everywhere will be blessed. And that's including us in here. So these are the ancestors of Jesus Christ, a descendant of King David and of Abraham. Abraham was the father of Isaac. Isaac was the father of Jacob. Jacob was the father of Judah and his brothers. Judah was the father of Perez. Perez is a funny name. And Zerah. Tamar was their mother. Perez was the father of Hezron. Now, we're going to skip to the end of the genealogy. Again, go back and read it. But there's some interesting stories within this genealogy. And just for time's sake, we're not going to read it all, but I just wanted to kind of set the stage for it. And then it goes to the end of the genealogies. It says this: these are 14 of the generations from Abraham to King David, and 14 from King David's time to the exile, because at one point they got captured and were taken in an exile situation, and 14 from the exile to Christ. And then let me go to the next slide here. And so let's talk about the birth of Christ. This is what Matthew's all about. We're setting the stage. This is the introduction to the characters. And he says, these are the facts concerning the birth of Jesus Christ. It's a very interesting story. And Matthew has a unique take on it. He says, his mother Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph. But while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant by the Holy Spirit. Now, I know some people are like, whoa, this sounds crazy. And you know what's interesting, though? A lot of the stories we enjoy have to do with the chosen one. I don't know if I just saw The Matrix this past week. I don't know if you've seen The Matrix, any Matrix fans out there. But whether it's The Matrix or, you know, Star Wars, or there's this story narrative out there about the chosen one. And in this reality, or in this story here, in this narrative, Jesus is the chosen one. And she, or Mary, was pregnant with Jesus. Now, let's look at this next part, because there's a little bit of a drama that happens with Mary and Joseph, because he did not believe her. He did not believe that this was a miraculous birth that was coming. He thought, oh, she cheated on me. And how do I know that? Well, it says this: then Joseph, her fiancé, being a man of stern principle, decided to break the engagement, but to do it quietly, as he didn't want to publicly disgrace her. All right, so imagine this for a second. We're just kind of dramatizing. Mary is like looking down at her stomach, and she goes, oh my goodness, you know, I'm starting to get a little larger. What's happening here? I got to stay off the carbs. A few days later, the stomach's growing bigger. She realizes, and the angel told her she's pregnant. Now imagine this conversation. She walks up to Joseph and says, Joseph, honey, guess what? I'm pregnant with the Son of God, and I'm going to have a child. An angel told me this. Now, be honest. Even if you were the super nicest person, you would think she was lying. You would think, who are you cheating with? Who is it? Tell me. I'm going to take care of them. And that's what Joseph thought. And he says here, he was going to break off the engagement. It was going to be over. But he was a really nice guy. He wasn't going to like make a, you know, big display out of it, embarrass her or anything like that. So Joseph said, you know, I don't believe you. You're crazy. Some story about an angel and a miraculous birth. Forget about that. He says, it's over. Well, man, even before Jesus is like on the scene, there's this crazy drama that's happening. Well, I don't know if it was the same angel, but another angel came to Joseph, and here's what he said. As he lay awake considering this, by the way, anybody like have a hard time going to sleep sometimes when something bad like this is happening, your mind's just up and just racing and you can't sleep? Well, this was Joseph. As he lay awake considering this, he fell into a dream and saw an angel standing beside him. Joseph, son of David, the angel said, don't hesitate to take Mary as your wife. And so the angel, I don't know if it was the same one, came to Joseph and says, it's true. She is going to have a miraculous birth. An angel of the Lord. It's going to be the Son of God, and the baby's name is going to be Jesus. And so Joseph's like, all right, this is crazy. Goes to Mary and says, I believe you. I thought you were lying. We were going to get divorced, but you're telling the truth. And so he took unto him his wife. And so the angel had a little more to say about this. And here's what he said. Let's see if I can get that next slide up. He said, the angel said, for the child within her has been conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you shall name him Jesus, meaning Savior, for he will save his people from their sins. Like, let's pause there. The reason Jesus came to this earth was to save us from all our sins. All the junk, all the regret, all the failure, all the you know, just junk in our lives that we don't want to have any part of. Jesus has come to save us from that. Addictions, failures, regret, you know, you name it. We can just put a big list. That's why Jesus came. Not because he's angry, the judgment of God, lightning, but because he loves us. He loves the human race and wants to help them out of the pit that we sometimes can put ourselves into. For he will save his people from their sins. This will fulfill God's message through the prophets. And the final verse, like I said, we're just doing episode one, an introductory episode to what's coming up in the next few weeks in the book of Matthew. We're kind of setting the stage. And here's the last verse for today. And then he continues by saying, listen, the virgin shall conceive a child. She shall give birth to a son, and he shall be called Emmanuel, meaning God is with us. If you forget anything from my sermon today, don't forget this one thing, that God is with you. He is with you to the end. He's always going to be with you through thick and through thin, through your great times, through your bad times, through your failures, through your victories. It don't matter. He is with you. And this message of Christ, that God is with us, endured through all those generations to come to this moment where Jesus is born, to let the world know, and even here in Rusty Church, that God is with you. Don't forget that. No matter the circumstances of your life, life's going great, God's with you. Life's falling apart, God is with you. You had a great week, God is with you. You had the worst week of your life, God is with you. It doesn't change how he feels about you. His name is Emmanuel. God is with us. Well, final thing here. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel commanded and brought Mary home to be his wife, but she remained a virgin until her son was born, and Joseph named him Jesus. And that, my friends, is episode one of the book of Matthew. And I'm looking forward to next week. Episode two gets a little crazy. I'm not going to lie. It has a little bit of vibe of The Mandalorian, this baby that people are trying to kill or capture. That same thing is going to happen in Matthew episode two, or chapter two in the book of Matthew. King Herod does not want anything to do with this baby. He feels threatened by it. And he sends soldiers out to try to kill the Christ child. Stay tuned. That's coming up, episode two, next week. Let's close in a word of prayer, everybody. Let us pray. God, if we don't forget anything, help us not to forget that God is with us through it all. And I just pray that we'd be encouraged by that thought. Bless this journey we're about to go on from the story of Matthew. And in Christ's name we pray. Amen. And as customary to end our services, we shoot in the sky. So that is the end of church, everybody. All right. Thank you, everybody. Appreciate it. We have a giveaway?
Yeah, giveaway.
Are you doing the giveaway, Fat? Right,
line up. Down the hall.
Oh, here we go. Giveaway time. Oh, thanks, man. These are donations. Hey, I appreciate that. Hey,
yo,
thanks, M96.
Thank you.
Even mine, there is two items for each person. Says Rico, no, Rico, can you drop the thing? That's not for you, no. He's gonna regret this.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, Rico. I meant to have you close in prayer. I forgot. I was just getting into it.
Nah, that's right. It's all good. Was another one.
There's a cassette there. That's some good tunes, man. That's some good tunes.
Hey, thanks for sharing. That was a great message.
Hey, thank you, Rico.
Thanks for visiting. Good to meet you. Good to meet you guys.
Should we just go running in a big line down the road? Let's go.
Yeah.
Right behind you, Rico.
Do it. Follow me, see.
Nope. I don't know either.
I don't know. You lead the way. Let's go.
We're just going.
Oh, look at this guy.
Poor guy.
Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
That's funny. Vandalism. This is kind of funny, I'm not gonna lie.
Alright, let's go to our post.
Yo, follow this horse guy. You like my singing, Twitch? You guys like my singing? I think there's only four of us left.
We're almost there.
I think the train derailed a little bit.
That was Detroit Spinners on Radio 2. Next is a tune. She competed in American Idol and got the yes vote for Katy Perry.
We're here.
This is Fingers Crossed.
We're gonna have to disarm it.
Number 9 in the hottest 100 of 2001, and that is the closest we're gonna take you to the top 10. You're gonna have to listen. You're gonna have to listen to find out what was going down in 2001 from 100. You're hearing it this Sunday, Gen 23, 10 a.m. local time.
Let's go back.
Nice to see you, son. So we talk business. Don't just stand there, huh?
Yep. I'm gonna take all these quests.
You bet. Don't just stand there, huh? Until next time. Adios, hippo. Adios, hippo. Hello, puppet.
All right, how do we TP back home?
Do home one. Home one. Do you have home, Marco?
Wait, what is it? Oh, yeah, got home. It. I know, right? It's kind of actually like soothing. Where's the. Yeah. Oh, here it is. Six days. Very nice. Very nice.
Challenge for you to try this week, and I've got a positivity playlist from listener Zoe. What a pack show we have for you today! This is BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker.
What is this?
I don't know, but it's funny, man. Oh, I fell all the way down.
BBC News at 11 o'clock. This is Nick Creation. The FBI has identified a British man who took four people hostage in a Texas synagogue as Malik Faisal Akram. 44-year-old from Blackburn was shot dead
after a terrible standoff with police in Corriveau,
a suburb of Dallas yesterday. The hostages were freed
unharmed. I think it's like a legit radio station.
Yeah, BBC.
Stage. Details have been emerging about Malik Faisal Akram throughout the day. I know you're gonna love it. Here's people feel.
Da 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 da. Hey, I'll catch you later, Rico.
Alright, see you around.
I'm gonna be streaming some that Apex challenge this week if you wanna join me.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Oh, I can't see the thing. Oh. Yeah, Beaky, come join us. I think you'll like this server. Well, actually, you're already in the server. What am I talking about? You go run around and do some rusty stuff. I gave you a bag, by the way. I think your bag is right. I think this is your Beaky bag. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is Beaky bag. Yeah. Beaky bag. Mm-hmm.